Here we're going to talk about what's called the absolute value in mathematics. And I've first drawn a number line. And let's first discuss the idea of distance on a number line. So if you were right here, we'd say you were at the origin. And if you're here, you're at the number positive 1. Now, if you were here, you'd say, oh, I'm about, you know, if these were miles, for example, I'd be 1 mile from the origin. And likewise, if you were located here, you'd be 2 miles from the origin, and likewise 3 miles from the origin if you were here. Now, if you're over here and somebody asked you how far were you from the origin, you'd still say 1 mile. So the point is that distance is always positive, even if the number you're located at happens to be negative. So for example, if you were located right here, you'd say, I was at a distance of 2 miles from the origin, and likewise here, you'd say you were at a distance of 3 miles from the origin. Now, the reason that's important is because absolute value is actually defined in terms of distance. So we say this, that the absolute value of a number, is the distance to the origin. And that's it. So for example, if somebody asked you, what's the absolute value of positive 2, the way you'd write that, or the way that question would be posed, would be like this. The absolute value of 2. So these little bars here, they're not parentheses, and they're not brackets. They're this new idea called the absolute value. So this is saying, what is the absolute value of the number 2? That's like asking you, what's the distance of the number 2 from the origin? And you'd say exactly what you thought up here. Oh, it's 2. The number 2 is 2 miles from the origin. And likewise, if somebody asked you, what's the absolute value of the number negative 3? It's the same logic. You'd say, well, the number negative 3 is 3 miles from the origin. Okay, now usually we don't say the word miles, but maybe 3 units from the origin. But the point is that distance, right, is always positive. Okay, and because the absolute value is the distance, the absolute value of a number is always positive. Okay, well, positive or actually can be 0 as well. Like, for example, what is the absolute value of 0? Well, that's like saying, you know, how far is 0 from the origin? Well, 0 is 0 miles from the origin. So the absolute value is always positive or 0. Okay, now the question is, where does the absolute value as an operation, right? We have addition, we have subtraction, we have multiplication, we have division, right? And we have other operations. Where does the absolute value fit into the order of operations? That's a good question. I'm glad you asked. Let's go ahead and look at an example. So let's say you were asked to simplify negative 3 multiplied by the absolute value of negative 2. Now, first of all, this is multiplication. It's kind of like having this, negative 3 multiplied by x. Now, nobody writes a dot right here. It's assumed to be multiplication, negative 3 times x. And likewise, nobody writes a dot right here. You have to know that that's negative 3 times the absolute value of negative 2. Now the question is, what do you do first? Because this is an issue of order of operations. There are multiple operations here, right? There's multiplication, and there's the new operation of taking the absolute value. Now the answer to that question can be thought of when we consider the acronym for remembering the order of operations. And here's what it is. Some people like to say PEMDAS. I like to say GEMDAS. So G, E, M slash D, and A slash S. Now, G stands for grouping, as we've discussed. Now, grouping, it turns out, can come in lots of different forms. It can take on different visual forms, I should say. It can involve parentheses, or you could see brackets to indicate grouping. You could also see what are called braces. Now, it turns out the absolute value falls under the umbrella of grouping as well. So the absolute value symbols are grouping symbols. And another example of a grouping symbol that we'll see later on is this. So this is what's called the square root symbol. So that's why I use G instead of P, because P stands for parentheses, but grouping symbols can have lots of different forms. And then as you make your way down the list, remember E stands for exponents. M and D are on the same level. It's multiplication and division from left to right as you read it in the problem. And then A and S stand for addition and subtraction, of course, again on the same level from left to right. So looking at this problem, I say to myself, well, what operations are involved? There's multiplication, but there's also absolute value. Now, remember, absolute value falls under G, and that comes much earlier than M. So we do the G first, we do the absolute value first. And so absolute value is kind of special in the sense that even though there's nothing to do inside here, you still can take the absolute value of the number negative 2. And so we do that first. This becomes negative 3 multiplied by what? By the absolute value of negative 2. And what's the absolute value of negative 2? Well, that's 2. So I'm changing this to parentheses. Now, I change this to parentheses to indicate two things. First of all, it's still multiplication, right? Because it's negative 3 times whatever that is. Second of all, it's parentheses and no longer absolute value because I already performed the operation of taking the absolute value, right? The absolute value of negative 2 is simply positive 2. And now it's multiplication, so it's negative 3 times 2, which is negative 6. Okay, so let's take another example of absolute value where it fits into order of operations or making use of it in the land of order of operations. Okay, let's simplify this one. This is 2 minus 5 multiplied by the absolute value of all of this. That's negative 2 raised to the fourth plus 4. So once again, I think about my order of operations, right? G, E, M slash D, and then A slash S. So G comes first. Do you see any grouping symbols? Absolutely, right? The absolute value. Now, with grouping symbols, you always do what's inside those first. So in the previous example, I didn't have anything to do inside the absolute value bars, but I do here, right? I've got to perform all these operations. Now, what operations are there? Well, there's addition, but there's also this, which is exponentiation. So we want to apply GEMDAS within the grouping symbols. So within the grouping symbols, I'm going to first do E. That is the exponential expressions. Now, when you simplify an expression using the order of operations, it's really important that we just take the whole expression and we rewrite the whole thing left to right. Now, I know that my attention is here, right? 2 to the fourth, but I'm going to write that in context as I'm writing from left to right. That is, I don't jump right here and write 16 because that'll throw off the spacing of my whole problem. So here's what I do. Even though the 2 and the 5, nothing's happening to them, I still write them out. So it's 2 minus 5. Okay, here we go. Absolute value of, well, let's see, 2 to the fourth is 16, and that negative is still there. So it's negative 16 plus 4. Now I know that this is not negative 2 raised to the fourth, because negative 2 raised to the fourth would look like that, with a negative in the parentheses. That's equal to 16. This is different. This is 2 to the fourth, which is 16, and then multiplied by negative 1. How do you know the difference? If there are parentheses, including the negative as part of the base, then you have to multiply the negative number by itself that number of times. And if there are not parentheses, the negative is not part of the base, and it's just whatever number you have there. Okay, now there's still work to be done inside the absolute value bars, right? Negative 16 plus 4, I'm at the step of addition, right? I'm at addition, but applied within G still. I'm still within G in GEMDAS. So it's going to be 2 take away 5, absolute value of negative 16 plus 4 is negative 12. Okay, and we're still at G, right? Because there are still absolute value bars. So what's the absolute value of negative 12? It's positive 12. So it's 2 take away 5 multiplied by positive 12. And notice how I changed to parentheses here. That's because you still have multiplication. And I didn't do the subtraction. Why? Because I'm not all the way down here yet. I just finished G in GEMDAS. Now I move down the line. No exponential expressions. M and D, yep, there it is, right? Multiplication. So it's going to be 2. And what we talked about before is that you can think of that negative 5. It's true this is subtraction, but subtraction can be viewed in terms of addition. And I can view the negative as going with the 5. And negative 5 times positive 12 is negative 60. And if you do that, the negative 60 is now just written as minus 60. And now 2 minus 60 is equal to negative 58. Okay, so we'll have more to say about order of operations, but this is an introduction to absolute value. Until next time.